Former President Jimmy Carter has vowed to see the last guinea worm die before he does. And with the parasite eradicated from all but 4 countries, he's close. But now the enemy has found a new place to hide. The guinea worm, Dracunculus metanensis, is a horrific human parasite. Its larvae infect tiny freshwater copepods, which then enter the human digestive system through unfiltered drinking water. The larvae then tunnel their way through the host's stomach and intestinal walls, where they mature and turn the human abdominal cavity into their own kinky sex cave. The males die in there, but each 2-foot-long fertilized female migrates to the host's skin, generally somewhere on the lower body, and causes an excruciating blister to form. When the host attempts to relieve the blister with immersion in water, the female seems to sense the temperature change, bursts out of the blister, and excretes her foul larva to begin the cycle anew. The entire human portion of this life cycle takes about a year, and that's when a plague of other symptoms pop up in the human host. Fever, itching, nausea, vomiting, diarrhea, and dizziness. Secondary bacterial infections commonly then result in painful disability that can disrupt the individual's ability to work, attend school, or care for family members. Now, this disability period typically lasts 8.5 weeks, according to the CDC, but it can sometimes prove permanent. That's why the Carter Foundation has waged a war of extermination on the guinea worm, cutting known infections down by 99.99% from 3.5 million cases in 1986 to just 7 cases so far in 2016. But with victory so close at hand, this inhuman adversary has found a new place to hide. Just as the alien in John Carpenter's The Thing took the form of a dog to outwit its human hunters, so too has the guinea worm jumped to man's best friend. As reported by NPR, dogs in Chad began experiencing guinea worm infections 3 years ago, sometimes harboring as many as 62 worms per host. Now, researchers aren't sure exactly how the jump occurred or how the cornered parasites are reaching their new host species, but 600 dog infections popped up in Chad this year alone. Part of the problem is that dog ownership in Chad, as with much of the world, isn't quite like it is in the United States. The animals generally enjoy semi-feral free reign, but they need to be tied up for a solid 2-week block if the worms are to safely leave their body and die on dry land. So the Carter Center is currently providing collars and chains. They're paying individuals to tie up their dogs in an attempt to corner the guinea worm and push this organism ever closer to the tipping point of total eradication. If you want to learn more about the Carter Center's guinea worm program, visit cartercenter.org. And if you crave more weird parasitic science, be sure to visit now.howstuffworks.com each and every day.